Hey fellow beauty finders, this is Matthias Allen. Thanks for clicking on my new video. So I'm going to be answering some questions today from some of my fans, subscribers, and personal friends who have been asking me, I need to know exactly what's in your kit and how it works and how you get to do what you do in the way that you do it. So I'm going to be answering some questions in today's Monday Makeup Chat. All right, so one of the questions that I get all the time is, how do I help clients with oily skin? Clients that have just a really large amount of oil or shine or sweat, you know, their makeup doesn't last. What kind of makeup should I use? Now, in a lot of my demos, I've focused on acne-prone skin and how to do makeup for photo shoots, which is, you know, something different than bridal. So today I'm going to answer that question, and there's so many different things you can do. It depends on what's in your kit, but I'm going to make some kit recommendations for you if you are working with oily skin clients. A foundation that I really love for oily skin, or skin that you know is going to be very hot or sweaty or, you know, perspiring or acne-prone skin, is the Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Foundation. Now, this Matte Velvet Foundation has been around for a few years. If they ever discontinue it, I will kill myself because the ingredients in here really help to mattify the skin. And it is a medium to full coverage foundation. It comes in at least 25 or 30 colors. I have it in about 10 colors, and I custom blend everyone's shade, you know, from just my 10 colors. It's this cute little bottle which fits great into your kit. A little bit goes a long way, and it is extremely mattifying on the skin. So that's a foundation that I love. Another thing you can really think about is buying a silicone-based foundation. Now, silicone-based foundations tend to stay longer on the surface of the skin without showing shine. Silicone is a molecule that will not penetrate into the skin. Now, if you have primed the skin, like I've discussed priming the skin, and then you use a silicone-based foundation like Urban Decay's Naked Skin, this foundation alone will just stay on much longer and will keep from breaking down if the skin starts to sweat or get oily. So the Naked Skin from Urban Decay is one of my favorite foundations. It is beautiful on the skin. It comes in a lot of different colors. I've used it in so many of my videos. And like I said, this is a silicone-based foundation, which is a recommendation if you are working with clients that tend to be oily or shiny. But overall, I think silicone-based foundations are phenomenal. Now, another thing that you should think about doing is setting the skin with a setting spray. Now, setting sprays like this one, also from Urban Decay, this is the D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray. Now, the D-Slick Makeup Setting Spray is designed for oily control situations, if you will. And this I've used in so many makeup demos. It's one of my favorite products. It's something that you can literally spray over the entire finish of your face and then let it dry and know that it's gonna really, really, really last. Another thing you can do with this that I learned from my fellow YouTube guru and makeup artist, Candace Shepherd, thank you, Candace, is that you can use the setting spray in layers. And what that means is that you can take a wax-based foundation, similar to anything like RCMA's foundation concealer palette, which I love. This is a wax-based product. Also, the Kat Cosmetics, which is another brand that I've been using a lot of recently, that is also wax-based. You can take cream foundations, which don't normally have like a waterproof texture to them or a waterproof component, and you can layer the products, meaning you can do a very light layer all over the skin, then spray your setting spray, let that dry, then go in with more foundation. Do another second coat, okay? Very, very lightly with a foundation brush or a sponge like this one from Esom. This is the Esom Pro Finish Sponge, which I love. I did a blog about this and how amazing it is, so check it out. And then you can do another coat of the setting spray, let that dry, and then you can build even more foundation on top. Now, like Candace says, you can build and create a much more long-lasting finish by doing this in steps and layers. Now, the next thing that I want to recommend is another technique you can do is you can take your sponge, your pro finishing sponge like this, or your traditional pink egg sponge, if you will, and you can saturate it with the sealer. And so rather than water, you can saturate it with the sealer. And then when you go into your foundation, you apply the foundation real quickly with a foundation brush or with your fingertips. And then with the sealer soaked sponge, you can manipulate and tap the foundation into the skin. What you're doing is you're adding a little bit of that sealer into the foundation. So it's similar to the technique that I just mentioned with the layers and the two and three, but if you don't want to do all that work and you feel like it's going to take too much time, just saturate your sponge and manipulate your foundation like that. So that is a great way to make the makeup last. Now the last thing I will recommend is get a powder puff, because the powder puff is gonna be your best friend. If you are setting a client who has oily skin with only a loose powder brush, and you're using, God forbid, just pressed powder of any kind, and you expect the makeup to kind of stay matte and shine free, you are gonna be in big trouble. A powder puff is gonna be your best friend. If you have an oily skin client, you really want to take your loose powder and you want to just get that loose powder into the powder puff, shake off whatever's excess, and really press and roll that loose powder into the skin. Because loose powder with a powder puff is going to really just densely mattify the face, and it's going to last much, 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 much longer. So I hope I answered some questions for you guys. As always, I would love for you guys to subscribe to my channel. I do weekly vlogs, makeup demos, and major transformations on my Fierce Face Friday episode. So please subscribe by clicking on the link right down here at the bottom. Follow me on all social media at Matthias for Makeup. And please, 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 before you go, check out one of these other two videos where I have done a major transformation or a bridal or glamorous look for you guys to check out. And stay with me here at Find the Beauty, and remember to subscribe before you go. Click the thumbs up tab and leave me a comment if you have any questions or suggestions. Thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.